Dear students, welcome to the new lecture in the unit of metals and nonmetals in organic synthesis. We have dealt with so far mercury and boron metals uses in organic synthesis, and in the previous lectures we have seen about the use of silicon as silanes in organic synthesis. Today we will be continuing with silicon, but in a different way. We will study the use of silicon as silyl enol ethers in organic synthesis. Silyl enol ethers play a different role in organic synthesis than the silanes. What we have seen about the silanes is one particular use of silicon. Now we will see about the silyl enol ethers use in organic synthesis. You have studied in your part one, that is semester two, enolates you have studied. Enolate chemistry you have studied about, whereby we can get that if a keto or an aldehyde is there, its alpha carbon possessing a proton, when it is treated with a base will extract a proton from here and the electrons will be redirected towards the oxygen. You will get this particular compound. This we call it as an enolate. If it is uncharged, then we will have OH group over here. So this we call it as enol. It is having a carbon-carbon double bond, so it is en, and a hydroxy group, so ol. So it is an enol. Enol will be there. If it is in an ionic form, then it is enolate. This has a lesser stability. In certain few cases only, it is more stable. Otherwise, it is less stable. Now, when it is less stable, we need to increase the stability of this particular enolate so that selectivity in the reaction can be brought about. More the stability of the enolate ions, more will be the selectivity. Regioselectivity, chemoselectivity और stereoselectivity अगर आपको reaction में चाहिए तो जो आपका intermediate बनता है वो intermediate stable होना चाहिए. जितना ज्यादा stable होगा वो intermediate उतना ही ज्यादा आपका reaction selective होगा. बस जितना ज्यादा stability होगा वो उतना ही उसके पास time मिलेगा उसे आगे का reaction choose करने के लिए. It can choose among the two. Whichever is present, or it is also that the intermediate jitna stabilized hoga utna hi uska aage ka jo transition state hoga wo higher energy ka hoga. Like we have it, if this is our reactant and this represents a product in our reaction coordinate, here if it, we have an energy transition state, then an intermediate, then a product. So ये हमारा जो intermediate बनता है ये अगर ज़्यादा stable होगा तो जो ये हमारा second transition state है, this second transition state का जो energy है हमारा, ये energy बढ़ेगा. And so as this energy increases, if there are two paths are there, then the one which is having lesser energy will be preferred over the other one. So there will be more preference will be obtained if the intermediate is stable. If our intermediates are stable, then we will have a higher choice or higher selectivity will be obtained than the ones which are shallow or intermediates or higher energy intermediates. Higher energy intermediates will have a transient existence. It will have a transient existence, and as it has a transient existence, it will be a highly reactive species. And so it will be reacting faster rate, and hence selectivity will be less. All the three selectivities, that is regioselectivity, chemoselectivity and stereoselective. All this will be lesser if the intermediate is having smaller existence. If the half-life time of intermediate is small, then all this will be lesser. If the intermediate is stable, then this will be higher. So if we can increase the stability of this enolate ions, then the reaction can be more selective reaction. All the three reactivities can be brought into place. So for that purpose, what we can do is, we can use this silyl groups. Trialkyl silyl groups or trialkyl silanes can be used for increasing the selectivity in this particular case. Like for example, if we have, say this particular ketone, we have it, and if we treat it with base, it can bring about two different reactions. It can bring about two different enolates. One will be this one, where the oxygen will be towards methane side or methyl group side, or the methyl group will be towards oxygen side, and in the other one, methyl group can be towards R group. Two enolates can be formed, and these two enolates can be trapped by using silyl or silanes. Trimethyl silyl chloride can be used to trap this particular enolates. What we can do is, we can take this ketone base and trimethyl silyl chloride simultaneously or together in the reaction chamber. RB flask में ये तीनों एक साथ लेंगे और फिर रिएक्शन करेंगे, तो जैसे ही इनोलेट बनेगा वैसे ही ट्राइमेथिल सिलिल क्लोराइड इसके साथ रिएक्ट करेगा, एंड यू विल गेट द प्रोडक्ट सिलिल इनोल ईथर्स. यू विल गेट द सिलिल इनोल ईथर, एंड ओवर हियर यू विल गेट द अदर प्रोडक्ट ऑफ इट. So both this silyl enol ethers can be obtained in this, and then it can be reacted. It can be reacted selectively to give us the, and this will be our E or Z silyl enol ethers can be obtained, and they can be used up for further reactions. Like if you have, say, it has been observed that if we have ethyl group instead of R and then enolate, then the selectivity for syn addition and anti addition is about 90:10. Syn to anti addition is about 90:10 for this particular isomer. While that of the other one, where methyl group and the ethyl are on the same side, there the enolate has selectivity for syn and anti as 40:60. So selectivity considerably reduces here, but it is much higher over here. For syn addition, in this particular case, syn is preferred, and there is higher selectivity also. For this 90:10 selectivity, we can obtain it, and hence the reaction will be stereoselective reactions can be brought about. So this type of selectivities can also be introduced with the help of this trimethyl silyl groups, that is silyl enol ethers. If you can use it, then we can easily get this particular selectivity. इसका जो सिंथेसिस है, सिंथेसिस इज वेरी इजी। जब भी आप इनोलेट्स बनाते हो तो इनोलेट्स बनाने का जो आपका रिएक्टेंट्स होते हैं, रिएजेंट्स एंड रिएक्टेंट्स, उसी के अंदर में आप ट्राइमिथाइल फिनाइल क्लोराइड अंदर डाल दो, आपका रिएक्शन फिनाइल इनोल ईथर आपको मिल जाएगा। So that becomes an easy way of synthesis of this. The examples for this can be obtained, like if you have a cyclohexanone and we react it with in presence of base, say triethylamine and trimethyl silyl chloride. We'll get this silyl enol ether. The silyl enol ethers, when they are reacted, it can form, like for example, with a electrophiles. This can be reacting with, say, this propionyl chloride, propionyl chloride. So we will get the adduct where this particular bond goes over here, and this will be attacking the carbonyl carbon with the replacement of chlorine. Will be carbonyl, and here we will have this particular product we can obtain. Similarly, we can have it for the acetophenone. If we have acetophenone subjected to silyl enol ether formation, form this silyl enol ether. If this is reacted with benzaldehyde, in presence of titanium chloride, this titanium chloride acts as a Lewis acid, so it will increase the electrophilicity of this carbonyl carbon of benzaldehyde by making an adduct with this oxygen, so that it will be forming, it will increase the electrophilicity of this carbon. And that carbon then can be attacked by this enolic carbon over here. Will be having PiCl3. So we have a benzene ring. So this can be in dilute HCl. We can obtain the product. So such reactions can very easily be carried out. Similarly, we can have Michael type of addition reaction also possible for this. Triethylamine with trimethyl silyl chloride will be forming Xylyl phenol ether. This when reacted with alpha beta unsaturated ketone in presence of Lewis acid or a base. You can have Lewis acid like AlCl3 or base like KF or tertiary butyl ammonium fluoride. Reaction is similar. Here, instead of directly attacking the carbonyl carbon, it will be a conjugate addition will be happening. So we will get a Michael addition product. So this type of product we will get. So this was for Xylyl phenol ethers. It's a small topic. Few reactions are possible for this.